Hello, year ones. Welcome back. Lesson 12 now. I'm Claire, and I'm going to be talking some more about numbers and countings. Mostly today, we're going to be looking at 10 frames, 10 and more. You'll need a piece of paper and a pencil. You might be using a scrapbook like I have. I've been recording all our lessons in the scrapbook. So our learning intention today is using more than one 10 frame to understand place value. We have been learning so much about the numbers 1 to 100 and ways to count. We've seen lots of patterns in the hundreds chart and in all the number sequences that we've used. We've practiced the counting principles, we've estimated and checked by counting, we made Y charts, we learned about subitizing, we made 10 frames, and we practiced showing more and less with 10. We've been very busy. We learned lots of new mathematical words, and I'm sure you're keeping a list of them just like me in the back of your scrapbook. And I was wondering, what did you do since I last saw you? Did you throw a dice and take the counters off the 10 frame like I suggested the last time? Were you able to count to 100 or past 100? Did you practice counting when you bounced the ball or clapped your hands or even jumped on the spot? Can you recognize how many with a 10 frame? Let's have a go now. How many on this 10 frame? Can you see how many there are on this 10 frame? Ah, I was tricking you because there's 10 on this one too. How about this 10 frame? Oh, I can't trick you, can anyone? I changed the color, but there are still 10. Well done. Let's try this one here. How many are on this 10 frame? Do you remember last time we talked about strategies? So what strategy did you use? Did you know there are 10 spaces, 5 on this side, and these are full, so there must be 5, and one more must be 6. 6 on this 10 frame. Have you practiced your subitizing by using dice? Have you thrown 2 dice and just known? How lucky am I? I got double 1. Do you remember we talked about doubles before? Let's have a look at that. 4 and 1, 5. Excellent. Let's have a little bit of a review of what we know. Shall we practice saying our numbers? Let me see if you can remember these numbers. Did you say 7? Excellent. What about this one? 26. Excellent. What about this one? 25. Beautiful. What about that? 39. Well done. And this one. I think this one should be a 9. Let's put that one there. And 55. Did you say 50 very clearly? Good job. And this one. 97. That's a big number. And this one. The number 8. And finally, our last one. What's this one? 34. Well done. Now, I wonder, did you notice that I have created 2 piles here? 2 piles. Have you any idea why I've put 8 and 9 and 7 separate from this pile here, which has 34, 97, 55, 39, 25, 26? Now, why would I do that? Do you know that that's using a mathematical term? These numbers are called the ones. Can you see there's only one number on each of those cards? One number. And these numbers are called the tens. And if you look at these numbers, they have 2 numbers on each card. Can you see that? 26 is made up of 2 tens and 6 ones. 25, 2 tens, and 5 ones. So these numbers here are all called the tens numbers, whereas these are called ones numbers. And I have a card here that tells you that name. Let me have a look. So these are the tens These are the tens, and these are the ones. All right. Now, I wonder, if you get a pack of cards, can you divide them up into tens and ones? Let's talk about those numbers in terms of the number names and the values we spoke about. We spoke about the ones and the tens. Our 10 frames can be quite useful for this, because when we think about our 10 frame, if we have one 10 frame, it can show us all the values from 0 to 10. And two 10 frames can show us the values from 0 to 20. If we think about those numbers and put them in the 10 frame, you'll notice that these ones that I've got in the ones pile, so the ones that are in the ones pile, only need one 10 frame, whereas the numbers in the tens pile need more than one 10 frame. So if I put in, for example, 8 into this 10 frame, let's do that right now. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the number 8 in the 10 frame. So the number ones need one 10 frame. But if I'm going to show some of the tens, I need more than one 10 frame. So let's show 26. How many frames do I need? Remember 10 and 10. But there's more than that, isn't there? 10 and 10 is 20. I need another one. So I'm going to show you 26 using all of these 10 frames. Let's put them in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, how many more do I need there for 10? Just two. So how many have I got now? 10 and 10 is 20. How many will I put in here? 26. Let's put in our 6. There we go. Whoop, put that one that way. All right, so here we go. Our tens frame, we needed three tens frames to show 26. Two tens, can you see that? Two tens and six ones. So the numbers, how we organize them, go tens and ones. The first number is always the tens, and the second one is the ones. Shall we check that against our number chart? Remember, all the ones numbers are up here until you get to 10. And then all of the ones below here, until you get to 100, have two digits in them. We call these, when they have one number, we call it a single digit number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are single digits. And then when we have two numbers, they're called double digits. And everything from 10 all the way to 100 has two digits. Can you see that? And they're called the tens numbers. If you remember, there's 10 numbers coming up to here, and another 10 to here, and another 10 to there, and another 10 to there, and another 10 to there. Does that make sense? You can count them all the way if you'd like, knowing that each line has 10 numbers in it. Each line has 10 numbers in it, and that's why they're called the tens numbers. All right, here we go. Some people know that we don't always just start at one. Sometimes we start at zero, don't we? Sometimes we start at zero. And of course, there are way more numbers than 100. So I know some of you are able to count way beyond 100. All right, so let's have a think about our tens and our ones, and think about a number. I'm just going to say a number, and you're going to tell me whether it's a ones number or a tens number. Okay, you ready? I'm saying the number 9. Did you know there was only one digit in 9? So it's a ones number. This time, I'm going to take a number from my number pack, and you're going to tell me whether it's a tens number or a ones number. Are we ready? Let's try that one. 97. Do you think that's in the ones? How did you know? Oh, it has two numbers, or digits, as the mathematicians like to call them. Two digits, a 9 and a 7. The 9 represents, that's right, 9 tens, and 7 ones. Let's go 9 tens. 1 ten, 2 ten, 3 tens, 4 tens, 5 tens, 6 tens, 7 tens, 8 tens, 9 tens. But there's now 9 tens and 7 ones. So I've got to the 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 97. Can you see that? 9 tens and 7 ones gets us to 97. Excellent. That's a good strategy for finding your ones and your tens, isn't it? So after this lesson, I think it would be a good idea if you get some number cards and divide them into tens and ones. Just like this. Here we go. I have a 10 number. That's an interesting one, isn't it? Because 10 sits on our top row where all the ones are, but it has 2 digits. So it can't be a 1, can it? So it goes into the tens pile, because 10 starts here. The tens start here. How about this number, 49? Is that a single digit? Would it be in our ones pile? Oh no, there are more than one number here, aren't there? So we know the mathematicians would say there's 2 digits. A 4 representing 4 tens, and a 9, 9 ones. So that goes into my tens pile. 50. Ooh, 5 and a 0. Is that a ones? You're right. It is not a 1. It's in my tens pile. 2 digits goes in the tens pile, and 1 digit goes into the ones pile. Let's have a look at some of our ones over here. Remember, they only have 1 number on the card, so they go into the ones pile. Ones pile. And 9 goes into the ones pile. Can you do that after this lesson? I will talk to you next time. Bye.